The defense attorney for one of the men charged in the killing of Ahmaud Arbery compared the prosecution to a public lynching. Attorney Kevin Goh, who was representing William Roddy Bryan Jr. in the trial, complained that black protesters outside the Georgia courthouse were a violent mob seeking vigilante justice. Take a look at the court TV clip.
This is what a public lynching looks like in the 21st century, with all due respect. They don't have to have 10,000 people outside. They don't have to have 100,000 people outside. Perception is reality. We have sealed these jurors off. We hope we have. We have sealed them off, and it doesn't matter how many people are outside. It doesn't matter how violent they appear to be. It doesn't take much. And you've got witnesses, and you've got jurors who are worried about their careers and their livelihoods when this case is over. And they'll be aware of what's going on. They certainly were aware of it before they got here. They talked about it during the voir dire process. Just because they haven't put a gallery up, they haven't put a podium up outside with a hangman's noose on it, doesn't mean that this isn't a trial, despite the best efforts of this court. This isn't a trial that's been infected by mob violence of a woke left mob. And whether people realize that they participated in that or not, I'd like to think that the vast majority of the people outside this courthouse really have no interest in anything but justice. I want to believe that. And from a lot of the people I know out there, I think that's true. But the perception is the reality. And the media have fed that perception and created a reality, whether it's true or not, just like other people have created a false narrative, and the falsity of that narrative has been made very apparent through the trial of this case. That becomes the reality. This is what a mob-dominated trial looks like in the 21st century, and we're asking for the mistrial.
The three men involved in the murder of Ahmaud Arbery are also facing federal hate crime charges. In April, the Justice Department returned an indictment alleging that Gregory McMichael, Travis McMichael, and William Roddy Bryan Jr. used force and threats of force to intimidate and interfere with Arbery's right to use a public street because of his race. It also alleges all three defendants attempted to unlawfully seize and confine Arbery and detain him against his will, according to CBS News. After the murder trial in state court comes to an end, the legal saga will continue in federal court. The trial in the federal case is scheduled to begin on February 7th, 2022. Thank you for watching. Please be sure to visit us at rawstory.com. And if you'd like to see more of The Raw Report, please like and subscribe. And join others who like their news raw too.